an experience.
So good day, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending on where you are. Thanks for joining in for this presentation. I'm very happy to be here on the 20th anniversary of OWASP. It's really like a landmark, and actually also for the OWASP SAM project, we're currently at the 12th year of the project. So we have been doing quite a while already, and we're here to stay. So that's definitely nice to see that we're getting to these anniversary events. All right. So the OWASP SAM project, I'll explain you in a bit what it is. But the project currently is led by two people, Sebastian de Leersnijder, Seba de Leersnijder, and myself. Seba unfortunately could not make it today, so I will be your host for this talk for today. And so for today, I want to give you a bit more of an impression of what is Open SAM, OWASP SAM. I'm not sure whether everybody is familiar with it, so I'll explain a bit. Okay, what is it used for? How is it? What was the model like? How can you use it? And also give you a bit more insight into, okay, what are we working on and where do we want to go with the project? Because we do get quite a lot of traction on the project, and we get a lot of feedback of users. And so the community is really growing of companies that are using the project. So it's very nice to see that there's a lot of interest in OWASP SAM as a project in itself. All right, moving on. All right. So what is SAM? So SAM, the acronym SAM stands for Software Assurance Maturity Model. It's actually a model that as a company helps you to reason about software security. Because if you think of it, software security can be perceived as a technical problem, but a lot of the problems that we face in organizations in software security are actually linked to the way you organize yourself as a company in thinking about building or verifying or acquiring software in your organization, and the way how you organize it and make it fit all together. So in that sense, this project is maybe a bit atypical in OWASP. It's not at all a technical project. It reasons about what should you be doing in a company to build or to acquire secure software. And how can you reason about how well you are doing and how can you improve? That's basically SAM, OWASP SAM in a nutshell. It's a maturity model, meaning that we define different levels of maturity, and it can help you to measure and to reason about where should I be going in terms of software security. So it's a measurable model in different levels of maturity. It's actionable in the sense that it provides you with guidance or clear, I would say, pathways on where you can be going if you want to improve yourself. If you say, I'm good where I'm today, that's all fine. But if you see that continuously or very often you're having issues in the development or in the running or the maintaining of your software, then OWASP SAM can really help you in reasoning about how can I improve myself as an organization. And it's very versatile. We explicitly and on purpose, make it independent of technology, of processes, and of organizations. Technology meaning whether you develop in .NET or in Go or in whatever JavaScript framework you wanna Angular or whatever JavaScript framework you wanna develop in, it's technology agnostic. So the framework will help you always into reasoning about how can I do things. It's process agnostic in the sense that whether you use waterfall development or agile development or DevOps development or whatever development process in the future we will be using to develop software, it can support it. So there's no fixed process type built into the model. It can support different process types. And it's also agnostic of organizations, whether you're a small or medium enterprise or a very large multinational company, whether you're a government or a commercial company, it's also agnostic of that, and it can help you as well. And last but not least, and I think that's, of course, that goes for all the OWASP projects, but SAM is fully open. So everything we do, it's available to the community, and we really want to Also, invite everybody to contribute as much as possible, because the more we understand how companies are doing throughout the world on building secure software, the better we can actually develop as a community and improve the status of software security. All right. So if as a user, why would you use SAM? The most important reason for using SAM is if you want to think of in a structured way about how you want to, what are the capabilities or how you want to organize yourself around application security in organization. It's a holistic and a structured approach. That's the bottom line of the model. But you can also, you can really think of using the model in different roles. And Oscar, you already mentioned that you're a CISO in development company. Well, as a CISO, we often see that CISOs are using the model to actually have a view on software development practices for security that is actually understandable to management. So our model is not at all a technical model. It reasons about in terms of non-technical activities and arguments. And in that way, it resonates very well with management. As a developer, you can definitely use it because very often software security is perceived as a developer problem, which is actually not at all true. It's developer is part of contributing to building secure software, but a lot of the challenges in secure software are not developer challenges. And so you can actually use it as a developer to also make the argument that other stakeholders in your organization should also take action and should also take responsibility in that secure software problem. As a project manager, you can also use it to make sure that the project delivery cycle becomes a lot more predictable and efficient, because too often it happens that you work on a project, right before delivery you start pen testing, the report is all red, and then you really have an issue. So SAM really helps you to think about shift left approaches to take security into account as early as possible. But also as a client, you can use OpenSAM. You can use it to understand, to argue about with your supplier on how the supplier is doing in terms of software security. So it can really be used from different stakeholder perspective, different roles. And that's actually the strength of the model. It kind of glues or binds together the different people that are involved in the software security problem. So we're currently at version 2. I told you our project is 12 years old now. Version 1 has been there for quite a long time. We did some updates on version 1, and we released version 2 last year, and in the beginning of last year, 2020. Why did we want to release a new version of SAM? Actually, there were a number of important arguments. First of all, we really felt that the core model, like the core structure of the model, needed an update. We needed to bring it in line with modern development practices. Like, it wasn't very well-tuned towards Agile and DevOps development. You could feel from the model that it was written for more like waterfall development. And sometimes it was difficult to kind of link it or align it to more modern development approaches. Also, the model was 10 years old. The previous updates that we did, we always made sure it was backwards compatible. Of course, that is really important if you reason in terms of strategy and improvements in an organization. It wouldn't make sense to change the model every 6 months, because then building a strategy around a model that changes every 6 months is really difficult. So we always kept backward compatibility as a very important element for our model. But we really felt like at this moment, at that time for version 2, it's not really a must to be backward compatible. It can be breaking changes that we're going to introduce. And there were breaking changes that we introduced. We also felt that in the previous model, there was sometimes logical glitches that we had to fix. Sometimes it was not so very, very clear why an activity was at a particular level, or an activity seemed to be missing at particular levels. So we wanted to work on that. And we also really wanted to work on quality and coverage for activities. What I mean by that, in the past, when you were measuring activities, you were always looking at more like coverage. How often am I doing this? For how many applications am I doing this? but not really at quality. So if there's like an example would be, do you have a software security strategy? And if you would say, okay, there is a one-page document in the closet somewhere, but nobody looks at it. Yeah, there is a software security strategy, but nobody uses it. So how good it is, how good is it used? That was not really part of the version one of SAM. So we really wanted to work on that element to make sure that we could also measure next to coverage, also quality. So we worked quite a lot on that. Second big element was we wanted to improve the production cycle, because in the previous, it was always doing updates to the model was difficult, because we had to do updates to the PDF and to the Excel sheet and to other the website and to other places where it was, but it was not really, it was difficult to keep in sync, and it was always difficult to build updates. So we really wanted to improve the production cycle to be able to generate new versions of the model more easily. We also stepped away from the PDF document as the primary publication channel, and we made the website primary publication channel because it's much more accessible to everybody. It's on the fly, you don't have to download it, it's much easier. And so we really focused on building a new modern website that is actually the primary publication channel. And of course, before releasing version two, we had a lot of discussions in the group, in the community. We had pre-releases and we had a lot of community feedback to make it into a really a good new version. That was really behind there. It was released last year. Many of you will have seen it, might have used it already, I assume, I hope, because it's really there for everybody to use. Maybe some of the highlights of the new version. First of all, I want to stress that simplicity has always been one of the key design goals of the model. We want to make sure that it's understandable to everybody that has a look at it. That's also the reason why we really keep our focus on having a kind of symmetric model that has different the same set of activities, the same set of maturity levels. And actually, we had to challenge ourselves several times to make sure that was really the case also in version two. People that are familiar with the previous versions will have noticed that there is actually a fifth business function being introduced. So the implementation business function in the middle is actually a new business function. It was not there before. And it was introduced to bring it more to improve the alignment with the newer development practices and processes like Agile and like DevOps. Because the building and the deployment is CI/CD pipelines, it's really a very at the core of these newer development methods, and we wanted to represent that in the model. We also introduced the notion of streams to make sure that the logical structure makes sense. I'm not going to spend too much time on that to explain. And we worked on that coverage and quality that I already explained before. And then the last element that we also introduced in version two is we really want to leverage on the community to make the model as workable, understandable as possible. So we introduced the notion of community level, community-driven guidance in the model. So everybody can actually add explanations, information to the model to be available to others. And it's actually at the core of SAM version two as well, community-driven guidance. All right. Of course, the maturity model, you typically use it to assess and to improve. In terms of assessments and roadmaps, actually not a lot has changed since version one of the model, since version 1.5 of the model, since the previous version. So it's still, you can still do the assessments based on a set of questionnaires where you actually measure the coverage and the quality. Coverage you measure by giving the answers to the questions. The quality is actually based on the sentences that are under these questions. So like for the first level of create and promote, the questions, do you understand the risk appetite? And the quality criteria there are actually, you capture the risk appetite of the organization's leadership, you organize the leadership vets and approves the risks. And these are actually all quality criteria that should be met when you answer that question. And if these are not met, you should not answer the question as positive. So we actually are combining the coverage and the quality elements there. But so in general, the way you assess in a company hasn't changed really. And the way you build roadmaps as well, you might have seen all these elements before if you have already looked at some. What we are working on is also making sure that next to Excel files to do assessments, we also have online assessments tools so that you can actually go to a website and do the assessment online with a tool rather than using Excel file for doing that. And that's actually ongoing work. There have been tools for that in the past. We're actually also working on new tools at this point in time, and one of the tools will be released soon. All right. The SAM suite, so everything, all the material around SAM has also undergone quite a substantial change over the past year. So since the release of version 2, we actually redid the way we actually share all the information with you. An important change there is that GitHub, while for us GitHub in the past was a contain everything bucket, so we put there all the sources, all the documents, whatever you had. Now for us GitHub has really slimmed down to really focus on all the sources of the material. I'll come back to that in a minute, but it means that a lot of the documentation, the guidance and all the surrounding elements that were there, training material and what have you, has all moved to a new drive that we've created. We've created that drive beginning of this year. And so all the content has moved to this drive, and it's accessible to everybody. It's an open drive with a lot of resources that you can use to use the model within your organization. And then, as I mentioned before, the website, we built a new website since version 2. I think it's a very, very neat website. Patricia Duarte has been spending a lot of time there, and I think she did a great job. And the website is the primary place to have a look at the model, and it's actually continuously updated. So whenever we do a small change to the model, the website is automatically updated to show you that change. So these are the three main sources of information if you're interested in SAM to have a look at. I'll give you the URLs of these also later. I want to spend a couple of minutes on the internal working, how we organize ourselves, because as I said before, we worked quite a lot on the production cycle of SAM. And so what has happened is that while in the past we were doing PDF editing and Excel editing and directly in those artifacts, where we are today is actually we read the entire way in which we produce, and everything starts from a set of YAML files. So the entire core model of SAM is represented in a set of YAML files. These YAML files are available for you to use, have a look at. But everything in terms of website, PDF, the Excel toolbox, the translation, which is ongoing, I'll come back to that in a minute, everything is driven from those set of YAML files. So the Git contains these YAML files. All the changes that we do on the model is on these YAML files. It's a single source of the truth, and everything else is generated from that. In our Git, we also have all the different projects are now structured. We've set up a new Git organization, OWASP SAM, and all the activities are structured in separate projects. So for instance, the toolbox is a separate project, the PDF generation is a separate project, translation are separate projects per language. So everything is separated out in separate projects, and there's quite a complex pipeline structure behind their Git pipeline to make everything automatically generate. It took us a lot of time to get there, but we're very happy with the fact that we can now, by just changing a YAML file, all the rest can be automatically generated in English in a second. In terms of versioning, we also moved to semantic versioning in the sense that previously, the versions were like version 1, version 1.1, version 1.5, but there was not really a very structured way in deciding when is a new version at stake, when we're going to release a new version. We fully moved to the semantic versioning way of working, using major, minor versions, and then patch versions. So that means that we can also much more easily generate new versions of the model. Yet we want to still focus on model stability, because as I said before, it doesn't make sense to change the model every 3 months. If you're building a roadmap in your organization, you have to have a stable model somehow. So the making sure that there is a good balance between the stability of the model and making sure that we can progress, maintaining that balance is quite important. All right, a quick word about translation. We have been working on translations over the past 6 months, I would say, to make sure that the model is available in a lot of different languages. We have set up a crowding setup for that. So there's at the moment 10 languages being looked at. Not all are represented on Crowdin yet. And actually some languages already indicated that they prefer to work not via Crowdin. For instance, Japanese is being worked on, but it's not being done via Crowdin for good reasons, language specific reasons. But so we're currently working on translating SAM from English in a lot of native languages to make sure that we can have a good outreach to the community. That's being worked on. It's not fully ready, but we're really putting a lot of focus on there to make sure that we advance and can publish the model in a lot of different languages. Okay, that brings me to where are we going with this? I want to look at where is this bringing us in the near future, and where is it bringing us in a bit more distant future. In the near future, the current focus with the project team, and the project team, just to make that clear, there's two project leaders, but there's a core team behind this of around 10 core team people that are continuously looking, working on this model. And it's really a team of people that are behind this project, definitely much more than the two project leaders that I introduced in the beginning. But so our current focus focuses on, first of all, to maximize the outreach of the project, make sure that we can reach as much companies as possible, as much people as possible. And we're doing that by making sure that we have, again, good PDF documentation next to the website. We're working on translations, and we're giving a lot of seminars and trainings around OpenSAM. And actually, hot news there, we also have we'll be releasing soon a train the trainer packet that can be used to train other people or other trainers in an organization. And it's specifically useful for multinationals, for instance, that want to roll out SAM to an entire to companies, to different countries in the company. You can actually use that trainer material to actually spread the knowledge of the SAM model and further more easily within the organization. So maximizing outreach is one. Improving the guidance, making sure that people know how to use this model. We're doing that in different ways. Actually, every month in our team call, which is open to everybody, we have deep dive sessions where we actually go always explain or focus on one particular security practice. So we do these deep dives. We discuss what should you do? How can you achieve this in organization? What are the challenges? How do people do it differently in organizations? So we focus on discussing these. We really also want to get community-driven guidance. So for instance, Rob van der Veer, for instance, have been writing guidance on how to apply the SAM model in an agile context. But at the same time, you could say, okay, we want to write guidance on how would you do this for DevOps, or how would you do this in an SME, a small and medium enterprise company. So understanding how we would apply a model in a particular context is something that we're really hoping the community can help us with to make it more clear. And we're also providing guidance in terms of links to other project reference OWASP projects, because in fact, SAM is a very nice umbrella view to think about all the different activities on software security. And in that sense, it actually links to a lot of OWASP other OWASP projects. We're also working on benchmarking because we get a lot of questions on this. Benchmarking is about making sure that we can have a way to measure what are different companies doing and to make that data available to the community. We're working on having a working setup available and also to connect the online assessment tools to this working setup. It's really a big demand from the community. We know it's really our core focus, and we're trying to put as many cycles as possible in moving this forward. And finally, project governance, to make sure that because it's an open project, there's a lot of pull requests, issues coming in, to make sure that the versioning, everything is under control from a project perspective. Because as I said, a lot of people are involved there, and we really make sure that we have a nice structure and a working structure on making the project work and move forward efficiently. And then on a bit longer term, SAM can be seen as an OWASP umbrella because it links to so many projects. So we really have the idea that it would make sense to use SAM as an OWASP umbrella. So we're having these discussions here and there to see whether we can make it work in that sense. We have the idea of also working on open API to make all the data and all the files and all the information available through an API. We really want to work on support for large scale enterprises because we see that there's very particular challenges that we could help companies with. And we also sometimes get questions about certification. Can you somehow certify for SAM? So that's also an idea that we're playing with. It's definitely not very concrete yet, but we're thinking about it. And of course, as with any open source project, every suggestion that you have in how we can improve the project is definitely welcome. So you can definitely reach out to us to give us suggestions on how we can further make it work in your particular context. And with that, I want to close off with just the URLs for the project. So you can reach us through Slack and through Git. All the questions, feedback that you might have, you can give there. And I want to thank our sponsors that support the project, and definitely also the core team that is putting their shoulders under the project, and the entire community to make this work and to make sure that the SAM project is working for you as a community, because that's what it's there for. And with that, Oscar.